alert. So after coming to devotional service, gradually we our alertness goes down. Gradually we become more and more lazy in God. So how that can be overcome?
Yes. After coming to Krishna consciousness, I'm repeating. After coming to Krishna consciousness, we quoted the Prabhupada, who says that devotees should be very, very careful, should be alert, not to repeat our vomit. The material life we have abandoned, we should not repeat them again. But Prabhupada is speaking from experience that for some of us, we have noticed that after coming to Krishna consciousness, after hearing, even after speaking about these things, we are doing them. Why? And what to do? The Prabhupada's question. Very good. One word. Only one word. And this word, Krishna said it is a demon. Bhagavad Gita 16:17. This one word, Krishna said it is a demon. What is that? Complacency. Complacent. 16:17. Atma sabda. Complacent. After coming to Krishna consciousness, the fire of material existence was pushing us, so we ran to Krishna. After coming to Krishna consciousness, Rupa Goswami said, pure devotion has six characteristics. One, immediate relief from material distress. Okay, I'm all right now. I'm all right now. I'm all right now. That is complacency. Complacent. Okay, I'm all right now. I'm okay now. The moment a devotee say, I am all right in Krishna consciousness, that means Maya. Maya has come back. Is it there? Prabhuji? Is it there?
Yes.
Yes. Read it.
Self-complacent and always
impudent. Self-complacent and always impudent, deluded by wealth and false prestige, they sometimes proudly perform sacrifice in name only, without following any rules or regulations.
Please, let us look at this verse very carefully. Majority of us are doing it in Christian consciousness. Majority of devotees. When we come to this movement, nobody promises us that if we join this movement, you are going to become a guru. Any one of us will preach like that in the street? No one promises you that if you join this movement, you are going to become a GBC. You're going to become a temple president, commander, manager, this, that. Anybody preach to us like that? Coming to this movement, now we are becoming stuck on these things. We are stuck. Now I am guru. Yes? Ah, who are you? Now I am the president. I'm immovable. Then, okay, you are president, you are guru, you are whatever you are, no problem. But are you doing your duty or you are a manipulator? Complacent. Always impudent. We do sacrifice only in name. We are doing our so-called devotional service artificially, not from the heart. And you don't for Krishna. It is not. The verse here refers to all of us, or to some of us. We should not think that Krishna is speaking to somebody else. Krishna is speaking to all of us. Let us look at our activities and see if it corresponds with this. Let us bring Krishna consciousness to our face to face, not just in the book. Majority of us are like that. Christian consciousness is inside the book. Christian consciousness does not exist in our life. We should make what we are practicing exist in our life. That's the responsibility for every devotee. What we are practicing should show in our life, in our person. That is Christian consciousness. So after coming to Christian consciousness, and the fire of material existence has been put out by the potency of bhakti, to become relaxed by position, by pain, by words. And now Christian consciousness is put aside. Complacency. That is the problem. Therefore, we should be very careful to see that our day-to-day activities in Christian consciousness correspond with Bhagavad Gita, correspond with what Prabhupada has given to us, and see if it is pleasing to Srila Prabhupada. All of us who are trying to follow Srila Prabhupada, let us examine our activities every day if it is pleasing to Prabhupada. If we are not checking to see if Srila Prabhupada is pleased with our activities, please try to understand. We are floating devotees. Floating devotees. Or we are cheating ourselves. Because Krishna consciousness, it is a practical thing, tangible object. We can experience it. So every one of us will check. My life in Krishna consciousness, is it pleasing to Prabhupada? If the answer is yes, Haribol, go ahead. If not, let us retrace our steps and live our life every day in Krishna consciousness. So Krishna said here, a yogis, a devotees, abandoning everything, not being attached to anything, they act fully. Not busy. They act fully for the purpose of purification by their mind, their words, intelligence, their senses, everything fully dedicated to Krishna conscious activities. And in this way, they are purified. We are acting for purification. We are here practicing to become purified, so we can be the best devotee that will give Krishna the best satisfaction. Therefore, let us check, we should check to see if we are actually blessing Prabhupada by our day-to-day activities in Krishna consciousness. It is not a matter of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama. No, it is not like that. It is beyond that. It is more than that. What is it? Is Krishna, is Krishna pleased with puja? Is Krishna pleased with our offerings? Is Krishna pleased with how we relate with each other? If Krishna is pleased with what is going on 24 hours in my mind, can we offer that to Krishna? This is Krishna consciousness. Try to understand. Alright? Srila Prabhupada ki.